much on behalf of the choir, and welcome. Good evening. That was Gloria in Excelsis by a man called Robert B. Anderson, who I believe is Canadian, but I did a bit of research and I found very little about him on the internet, so I don't know why. He's a bit of an unknown composer. Hands up if you've heard that piece before. There we go. There you go. See? It's an unknown one, but it's a really lovely, lovely song. And we've got lots of lovely tunes to sing you tonight, because it's a mixture of Christmas, festive music, and other. We started rehearsals in September, and we obviously didn't do Christmas music in September or October, because that's just not what we do. So we're going to sing you a few of the songs that we've learned earlier in the term as well. So I hope you enjoy the mixture. Okay, we're going to carry on now with a carol, which you may have a sheet with words. There are three opportunities for you all to sing tonight, and stand and sing would be lovely, because it's always better to stand and sing. The first one is O Little Town of Bethlehem, okay? And there are two versions of this song, or this carol, I should say. There are two versions of many carols, I've since discovered. We're going to sing the one written by Vaughan Williams, okay, which is just beautiful. It's not actually his tune. He set it to an English folk song, which the name escapes me. I think it's on here, called Forest Green. So if anybody's into traditional music, so there's an English tune called Forest Green, which is the O Little Town of Bethlehem tune that we are all familiar with. So please stand and sing with us verse 1, 2, and 4 of O Little Town of Bethlehem. Let's get into the Christmas festive spirit.
Silence.
very different now for you. We're going to sing an African lullaby unaccompanied, which is called Suale, and Suale means good night. So this is one we learnt early on in September in the term. And we're going to sing, it's a very simple song, but it's very effective. And the opening verse, as it were, is going to be featuring just five singers from the choir, and then the rest of the choir are going to join in. So this is Suale. Suale. Liven things up a little bit. Another song that we learnt early on in the term is a kind of a big choral classic and a favourite of singers all around the world. And it's The Rhythm of Life from Sweet Charity, the musical. It was written in 1966 by Cy Coleman, so massive Broadway hit. We're going to perform a slightly shorter and simpler version than the original. Which is actually very complicated if anyone knows it. This is a little arrangement I've done it's in three parts, so you'll hear a kind of a cascade effect once we've all sung it through once. So I hope you enjoy it. This is The Rhythm of Life.
Do be 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 do
recognise that one? Yes, a lot of people did. Okay, great. We've come to our second congregational sing. They're not all carols, so I've got to be careful what I say. This one is Silent Night, one of the most well-loved Christmas carols ever written. This one's by Franz Gruber, Silent Night. Originally, the German words would be sung, but some people sing German, some people sing English. We're going to sing it in English tonight. But he was actually Austrian, not German. Okay. So we have the second verse. The choir will sing on their own. But I'd love you all to join us for verse 1 and 3. So please stand and join us for Silent Night. Generation to generation. We're going to sing a traditional song now, which comes from America, the Americas, and dates back to the early 19th century when the fur traders were traveling down the river Missouri. So the song, you might be able to guess this already, is Shenandoah. And Shenandoah is the name of the chief of, I don't know how you pronounce this, Oneida? No. I've got that wrong, haven't I? I'm not sure. I should have checked that. Okay. Well, maybe that's right. Okay, he was the chief. So he gets a mention, Shenandoah, in each of the verses. If you don't know the name of it, I'm sure you'll have heard this tune before. It's very, very well loved and very well sung around the world. Shenandoah. Which also has two versions. We're not doing both of them. It's after this one.
I've got new music in the
In the Bleak Midwinter has two fantastic tunes. You've probably sung both of them or heard both of them over time. They're both wonderful, and they're both setting to the gorgeous words of Christina Rossetti. Okay. So, and she's written fantastic poetry. I'm composing some music at the moment, which is based on her words for choirs. So we're going to sing the one by Gustav Holst, which is the traditional one, I think, that most people know. But the other one is lovely as well. So this was published as a hymn in 1906, In the Bleak Midwinter.
Oh,
it's Ruth's big moment. She's making her way across to the other side of the piano. We have a very exciting piece to present to you, hopefully. She's about to pick up a saxophone. So the next piece is probably a piece you've never heard before. It's Christmassy, and it's an arrangement of We Three Kings by me. I studied music down in Colchester and did my degree down there, and I wrote this carol for the college choir, and it won the carol competition. And it had a saxophone, it had piano, it had drums and all sorts. We're not doing the drums tonight, but we're doing everything else. So it's probably our most complex piece of the night, so bear with us. It's taken a few rehearsals to get to grips with, because it's in four-part harmony, which is not what we've done on all the others so far. So, wish them luck, and I hope you enjoy our version of We Three Kings.
Bye.
terrific hand for the sax player and the pianist. That's only the second time she's played at that. Yeah, and it was about 3 or 4 weeks ago, wasn't it? So, oh, there we go. That's it. Fantastic. Hope you enjoyed that one. Right, so now, something from, according to my list here, something from Scotland. We've got any Scots in? Yes, great. Yes, great. Oh, yes, great. I'm surrounded by Scots. That's fine, I don't mind that. I always thought I'd marry one, but I never did. Right. I always hoped I'd marry one. It just never happens. No, no. I'm more than happy with my lot. Okay, so we're going to sing you. This is a song which I've recently become acquainted with. And it's thanks to this lovely group of people, because as you know, I've recently taken on this this musical director role, and they've got a whole wad of music from previous years, and I had a look through, and this song is just a winner, a really real winner, and it's written by a Scot called Sandy Wright from, let me get it, Midlothian? Yeah, Midlothian. And we're going to do an arrangement of it by another person who lives very close to Sandy, called Corina Hewitt, who is a fantastic folk musician. She's a world-famous harpist, and she's a gorgeous singer as well. She's performed around here many times and done workshops and things. So she's obviously been very taken with his composition and wanted to help spread the word. So she's done some workshops based on it. Anyway, I've found the music, and I loved it. And I said, can we do this one? And they were all in approval, I think. So we'll sing you My Shining Star. And it's a lovely, lovely sentiment. It's very apt, actually, at the minute, because the first line is something about when the storm was raging and the night was black. Okay, well, we've just had one and we've got another one to come. So I think we can relate to that one big time. But really, what it is about is it's about, I think it's written from personal experience. So Sandy Wright must have lost somebody close to him that he loved, and he didn't think he could ever love again. But then one day he met somebody in a bar, and it happened, and it's just wonderful, and he's obviously expressing himself through the song, and he was able to love somebody again. So that's the song. Hope you enjoy it. You're not allowed to cry. I think it must be your turn again now. Okay, everyone's working very hard. They're not laughing at you, honestly. No. Just a little private in-choir joke, that is. So, we have one more on the sheet to sing, and it is, I believe, White Christmas. Is that right? So we've got two more altogether. We'll do White Christmas, swiftly followed by our final number. And interestingly enough, both songs were written within a year of each other. Okay? 1942, White Christmas, 1943. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. So we're going to finish with that one in a minute. Okay. What can I tell you about this one? They're both obviously American. This one is written by Irving Berlin, as you probably know, for the musical Holiday Inn. Okay, White Christmas. And was made very famous by? Bing Crosby. Absolutely. Okay. So if you sing it through once, we're going to do it twice. You're welcome to join us. We're going to do a bit of whistling. So if you're up for a bit of a whistle on the second time through, get into the spirit of it, and then bringing the words back in to finish. So if in doubt, just listen. But everybody sing it together to start with. Come on, let's have a go. Right, everyone on their feet. Let's do it. Let's do it. White Christmas. Are you ready? Oh, she's moved onto the keyboard. Hopefully it still works. Very grateful for power these days, aren't we? Okay. Take it away. And very interesting. I wonder if the choir or anybody in here knows that there are two versions of the lyrics of Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. And I didn't know this till yesterday, and I thought it was very interesting, doing my little bit of homework. It was made famous by Judy Garland in the musical Meet Me at St. Louis. Okay, Meet Me at St. Louis. And it was written, sorry, I must say, by Hugh Martin and Ralph Blaine. Now, Judy Garland was actually very critical of the lyrics of the song. and criticised the composer and said, it's lovely, but I think it's a little bit too sad and it's going to make people cry. Is there any way you can change the words? And he didn't want to do that, being a composer, but eventually, with lots of persistence, he did change the words. And then Frank Sinatra recorded it and made it very famous a few years later, and he used the new lyrics. Now, you're dying to know what the old ones are, aren't you? Right, so listen out. I'm really glad that they changed them. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. It may be your last. Next year, we may all be living in the past. God! Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Pop that champagne cork. Next year, we may all be living in New York. I'm really glad they changed it. So I hope you enjoy the new version. I know, which is much, much better. Thanks to Judy Garland, who obviously, yes, felt very strongly about this. Here we go. So, oh goodness, I think I've got to do a bit of singing here. Yep. Just remembered. Take it away. Welcome is the heavens above, by the way.
When the steeple bell sounds it say, they don't play it in tune, but the welkin will ring one day, and that day will be